HVAC technology is available and present in our life. But what we know about HVAC? Public opinion is that contractors' cars are driving into traffic and go to buildings to make maintenance. Or we can see some plumbers doing some maintenance in our facilities. Also, we can see some physical things, installation in the ceiling, like pipelines or ductwork. That may be the common understanding what HVAC technology is. However, can we imagine our life without services that HVAC technology can provide to us? I believe our life is totally different without HVAC. We are used to have warm water in our facilities, in bathrooms. In Finland, we love to go to sauna in apartments. And without HVAC technology, that's not possible. Heating and cooling and ventilation makes our buildings more comfortable. We don't know those if they don't working, but they provided us a lot of comfort. However, there's still space to improve. Some areas, in cold areas like in Japan, it could be that buildings are too cold and even elderly people can die in their houses. In developing countries, indoor cooking is the biggest health risk. And in Nordic, we are used to make complaints if indoor quality is good enough. And our perception is very high for indoor climate conditions. But why HVAC technology really matters? We can think about much more sustainable things because we spend over 90% of our time in built environment. And what kind of conditions we have there is very important for our health and comfort. There's a lot of scientific evidence that if temperature will rise up from 22 to 30 degrees, our performance reduce, and it's estimated that 30% of reduction of productivity could happen. And if we compare that cost for our energy cost or life cycle cost of the buildings, that could be even 400 times higher. So buildings are relatively cheap compared, and the maintenance of that compared for the workers. During the pandemic time, we have noted that airborne could be one possible risk of spreading the viruses. And how the ventilation and air distribution work has significant effect of our health. Also, buildings consume a lot of energy, and if we want to prevent global warming, we have to do something with the building energy efficient. And it's estimated that buildings consume about 40% of the total primary energy. If we compare that for the traffic, that is 30% or flight, 1 or 2%, buildings are much more important to stop global warming. In Nordic conditions, like city of Helsinki, about 58% of the total CO2 emissions are coming from heating of buildings. Buildings also consume a lot of materials, and it's estimated that about 50% of all materials extracted from the earth crust are transferred into construction materials and products. And thus, recirculation and sustainable thinking is very, very important. We have to cut our CO2 emissions to stop global warming. And we have put a target to make a reduction of 80% of emissions by 2050. And how we can do it? We have to do something for our existing building stock, where HVAC systems is playing a key role. We have a lot of possibilities. We can use renewable energy sources, solar energy, solar thermal, solar water voltage to increase building energy efficiency. We can also increase flexibility of the buildings and make them more smart to work together with smart energy systems. And I can estimate that in the future, the buildings are smart to control their performance and handle their energy efficiency. However, we should not forget users. The whole focus should be user-centric, and we must guarantee high quality indoor climate. Users' health is very important. Finally, I have to say that buildings are made for the people to live and work comfortably, effectively and safely. That's the main target.